Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture of Quality and Reliability Engineering. I am Milan Trivedi, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. So from the last few classes, we are discussing about chapter number 2, that is Total Quality Management. In this particular chapter, we are discussing about the different tools and techniques in order to improvise the quality. Up till now, we have discussed about the different tools such as Quality Circle, YS, problem solving processes such as DMAC method, PDCA cycle, total quality control, total employee involvement, quality function deployment, and in the last class we studied about a very interesting theory, that is failure mode effect analysis, FMEA. Continuing the same topic, the next theory is the Kaizen. Kaizen is one of the most important tool in order to improvise the quality. So let's get started with it. So what is Kaizen? Up till now we understood from the word itself, you get the conclusion that this word is coming from Japan, right? As it appears like a Japanese words. Even 5S technology, all the different words, Siri, Siton, CISO, that was the Japanese word. From the word itself, we come to know that this is a Japanese word. So yes, Kaizen is a Japanese word, but this theory is not given by a person called Kaizen. Kaizen actually in their terminology, it means continuous improvement. For continuous improvement, they are giving this word Kaizen. Basically, Kaizen means small improvements but carried out on a continuous basis involving all people in the organization. Right? They want involvement of each and every person throughout the organization, and they believe that there should be a continuous improvement without any shortage or any stop in between. You need to go for a continuous improvement, right? Whether it is a very, very, very small improvement, although you need to go for that improvement. In order to understand that topic, let us hear about a very interesting story. This story, we all know that is the story of hare and turtle, right? They both go for a race. We study this story in our childhood days. So, tortoise is a very slow mover, rabbit moves fast, but what happens? Rabbit take a halt in between. He thought that I ran a lot enough and I will won the race. So he take a rest. But turtle at the other end, he is taking a small step, but he is taking a continuous step. Right? So ultimately turtle wants. Right? The same theory applies over here. For the quality improvement, you does not need to go for a giant step, then you take a pause. Right? You need to develop the quality with very, very, very little steps, but on a continuous basis, right? And this can have a huge impact on the quality part. By implementing such theory, it has been proved that we can get a lot of benefits by implementing a Kaizen. There will be an improvement or increase in the productivity, right? The second one is we can have a better safety. Even see the TQM concept says, total quality management concept says that there should be a satisfaction of external customer as well as internal customer, right? So coming to the internal customer part, we need to be precise about the safety also, right? The worker should not get harmed by any of the process of the manufacturing, right? By implementing such Kaizen steps, continuous improvement, you can have a better safety even. You can have an improved quality, right? That is actually the main effect of the Kaizen. You can have an improved communication, right? That can be understood when we understand one case study also. You will get the idea about this improved communication. Then higher morale and employee satisfaction can be achieved. Because see, what can happen is, if any employee has been given a big task that you need to do this much, right? So obviously, many of the confusions will come up in his mind, or he may not be ready to for a big change, right? But what if he has been allotted with very, very small tasks so that he can manage that thing in a very easy way? So obviously he will be satisfied and do that thing as per his willingness also, right? So, and at the end, that small improvement is also having a huge impact, and I will prove that thing right now in my next slide, okay? But the concept of Kaizen says gradually unending improvement, doing little things, better setting, and achieving higher standards. Okay. Under the Kaizen, we are having one more thing that is called as a Kaizen umbrella. If you want to have a small improvement, you can do any of the things which is under the umbrella of Kaizen. Under the umbrella of Kaizen, these are the things you can manage. You can think about customer orientation, means what customer wants. You can think about total quality control or any of the Six Sigma tools. About Six Sigma tool, we will come later on. You can have a robotics in your particular industry. You can go for a quality circles. Quality circle we already understood in our tools and techniques first lecture. Suggestion system you can have. You can have a automation so that you can have better improvement. You can develop a discipline in your workplace. You can go for a total productive maintenance so that entire product developed as a defect free product. Then you can go for a Kanban. Kanban is again a Japanese manufacturing system in which along with the each and every process we write something. We will discuss later on, but it is a kind of a manufacturing, Japanese manufacturing process. Then another one is a quality improvement tools such as just in time, right? Just in time is actually focusing on the elimination of different 7 kinds of waste which company do, right? We will discuss that in later on because that is again a part of our syllabus, but we are discussing it during Six Sigma, right? Then zero defect, small group activities which can improve the quality. You can have a cooperative labor management relations so that quality can be improved. Productivity improvement, maybe trainings can be provided for that, and new product development so that it can be focused on the quality. Right? These are the small steps in the areas in which you can take small steps so that quality can be improved. Right? But I am coming to one fact that small improvement, how does it have a huge impact? For that, let us take a small case study. Say for example, if you are having a 1% improvement of your work each and every day, only 1% you are improving, right? It is not given a task like that, right now we got the 80% result, come up with the 90% result, right? It does not need to have a 90%, only 1% means if you are having 80%, you need to achieve 80 plus 10% of 80 means 80.8%, right? Small increment is required. Now if you improve by 1% every day for a 1 year, see overall at the end of the year you will have a 37% of improvement, right? But if you see at the other end, instead of improving, suppose if you are getting worse result, then what is the loss? Loss would be only of 0.03%, but if the profit would be, then it would be of 37.78%. Simple mathematics as shown here, right? So they believe that you need to consistently go for small improvement, right? For this, let us take the case study of Siemens. We all know these names, right? Very popular name in automation. And I am taking a Siemens case study of Ustkamp area, right? Siemens is producing electronics components. The employees are now problem solvers. They had implemented the Kaizen in their industry, right? So what happened at the end of the result, all the employees are now in a problem solving mode. Whatever problem happens, they try to solve by its own. Right? When a defective product was found, it used to take days to find the problem. Now they can see it right away and make adjustments. Right? They, after having a long practice of small improvement, they are in such stage. They were able to reduce the cost of inventory by 30%. Now this is actually the big thing, right? Inventory means stock of either raw material or finished good. If it has been stacked inside your storage area, it is occupying a large space of industry, right? So that is actually a loss to the industry. Because if the entire storage space has been filled, they cannot produce a new thing, right? So inventory reduction is the prime thing. Lead time for the brake coils went from 12 days to half a day. Lead time that is total time to repair these things was taking 12 days, now they had done in just half of the day. The number of product types has been reduced by 33%. Storage area was also reduced by 10%, right? They can reduce the space and utilize. See, after a small improvement, you can get a huge result. That actually I want to show over here, right? So, whatever the end result you require is, try to go for a small change. And this can be applicable even to your result also. if you are, as I told right now also, if you are coming with, let's say, 80%, right, you cannot directly think about 95%. You may have a small target, right, but at the end, or getting at the end of the result, or at the end of the examination, you may score well, right? So try to have a small improvement in each and every stage of life even, right? So that is nothing but it is all about the Kaizen. We are keeping up to this. Still more tools to discuss, but that will be discussed in the next class. Thank you.